Morning, church family.
Morning.
You can tell I'm a little nervous. Very nervous. But I know I'm around family. So Pastor Fleming, our guest speaker, Reverend Drain, other ministers, official officers, visiting friends, and other members, we thank you for coming. Morning View Baptist Church is a beacon of light in the Memphis community. With that being said, the membership is composed of those that are of Christian character that not only talk the talk, but walk the walk. Pastor stated last Sunday that we are to let our light shine before men that they may see our good works and glorify the Father in heaven. As a young man in 2016, it is refreshing to know that I am surrounded by men of dignity, valor, and good character, that I might have a hopeful future, and others are here every Sunday. Today, we would like to highlight a few men. Now, don't get me wrong, all the men are very outstanding. But we would like to just take a time and recognize a few. Now I will turn it over to Deacon William Talbot.
Amen. Okay, two people I'm going to recognize, we talked about before, and they are the winners of this year's A Taste of Morning View. So please, at this time, the winners, will you please come forward? That's Deacon Garrett and Deacon DJ Chef Jameson. And as I stated before, we didn't anticipate having a tie, so we didn't have a tiebreaker scenario. But I guess we're going to have to write that into the rules next year. But because of that, both of these gentlemen won first place. And I guess I'll just go in the order of alphabetically. And the plaque reads, first place, second annual, A Taste of Morning View, April 9, 2016, Sweet Southern Souls, Deacon Robert Garrett, team captain. The Italian Experience, Deacon Chef DJ Jameson, team captain. We want to thank them. Hold on a second. We're going to thank them. We have 10 seconds.
Thank you. And Brother DJ, it wasn't in alphabetical order. It was in tastefulbetical order. Thank you. We're so glad that you guys came out and enjoyed the Taste of the View, and it has become an annual event. This is our second taste, my second championship. And I would like to recognize all of my team members who were on the Taste of the View. Would you stand, please, just for a second? All the team members together. All the team members on the Taste of the View. I appreciate you so much. And next year, we're going to be bigger and better.
Well, anyway, can my team please stand? All right. Like we said, Italian Experience now. You know I got the Godfather on my side. Now, I'm starting to think, you on their team?
No.
I'm starting to think you on their team. But anyway, we want to thank you all for coming out. It was very enjoyable. And next year, it's going to be big and better.
Miss Katie Holmes used to tell us when we was in BTU that you need Christian recreation sometimes. So this is part of our piece for Christian recreation. And as always, we lift up the name of Christ. Next, I want to bring up someone who's going to do a special presentation. Somebody that grew up in this church, a childhood friend of mine, Lorenzo King. Come on down. First, I would like to say, I feel like I'm still at home. I did go to Morning View, I was baptized here, sang in the same male chorus, and sure did direct a few songs way back in the day. But it kind of brings to mind a song that I know probably most church members here remember. And by being Men's Day, my uncle used to sing in this male chorus, Charles Livingston. Yeah. He used to sing a song called Yes, Lord. And I was thinking about it today, and it kind of, one of the verses is, I woke up this morning, Lord, clothed in my right mind. Yes. I looked in on my family, and everything seemed just fine. But as I looked towards heaven, I couldn't help but stop and say, Lord, you brought me safe thus far. I want to thank you for another day. And that's been on my mind because I'm here today to pay homage to my father. I can remember my mom and dad arguing sometime on Sunday mornings because he wanted to make us go to work with him lay bricks. And she would tell Clarence, now, you can work with them boys Monday through Saturday, but Sunday they going to church. But I didn't understand it as a child, but he taught all of us work ethic. To get up and go to work. Work for what you want, don't steal, don't try to cheat anybody out of town. And I saw him work and work and work and more work. And I've seen my dad's health at his peak and I've seen it at his worst. And I'm here today at this particular Men's Day because he was supposed to be here last Men's Day. He was at home getting dressed. Nose started bleeding. My mom couldn't get it to stop. They ended up having to call an ambulance. He was transported. Stayed in the hospital for several weeks. And it was kind of touch and go for a while. And he's been battling and battling and battling. And I can see that he has come a long way from where he was. And that's another, that brings another song, like again, male chorus. He's come a long way, but he still got a long way to go. So we just wanted to recognize my dad. But before I go any further, I want to thank my grandmother, in addition to God, for him being here. And that's her sitting right here on the second row with the black hat on. That's my grandmother, my dad's mother. And she was 99 years old. Secondly, I want to thank my mom because I can remember her staying up late at night, getting my dad's medication laid out, what pill he's supposed to take at 10. What pill he's supposed to take at 2.
which pill he's supposed to take at 12. And she would lay him out, she would stay up. She tried to stay out of the hospital when he was up, when he was in the hospital, when everything was going on, but we had to give her a break because she just can't sleep on those carts out there. She tried to spend the night every night at the hospital with my dad. And this rest of the guys from the King Livingston family. And again, some of the other guys, y'all recognize some of their faces. Some of them grew up here in Morning View, and some of them are cousins, relatives, and married to the family. But we just want to come as a solidarity statement to let my dad know all the men in this family support him, we appreciate him, and we admire him. And we have a plaque. By the way, y'all want, this is my little bitty son right here. The plaque, oh, he's coming down.